Hello, my dear students. Today we are going to learn The Portrait of a Lady, and this story is there in class 11th Hornbill book, which is written by Khushwant Singh. Khushwant Singh is renowned Indian writer, editor of the newspaper and lawyer as well. So before we go into the story, let us talk about Khushwant Singh, to whom India is indebted. Okay, so the writer Khushwant Singh was born on 2nd February 1915 in Hadali, Pakistan. When he was born, India was not divided, okay, between India and Pakistan, right? He died recently on 20th March 2014 at Srijan Singh Park, Delhi, India. He was an author, lawyer, diplomat, journalist and politician by profession. He was lawyer in Lahore High Court for 8 years. And he gave his service in Indian Foreign Service as well. He was journalist of All India Radio 1951, Department of Mass Communications of UNESCO at Paris 1956, also received his service. Then we find him as an editor for many news magazines. He was Member of Parliament in Rajya Sabha as well. When we talk about the awards, he has received Padma Bhushan in 1974, which he returned in 1984 because he was protesting against Operation Blue Star, which was related to Indian Army's raid in Amritsar. Okay. He also received Padma Bhushan in the year 2007. Let us know a few more details about his literary contribution. His last book, The Good, the Bad and the Ridiculous, okay, has earned many readers yet. The Mark of Vishnu and other stories, The History of Sikhs, Train to Pakistan was very famous, where he talks about the pain of separation of India and Pakistan. Okay, he talks about partition of India in this book and the problem that Indians and Pakistanis encountered during this division. Okay. I Shall Not Hear the Nightingale is another work. Then we find The Six Today, The Fall of the Kingdom of the Punjab, and many more. Okay, I have mentioned only few, but he has contributed many more through his writings. Okay, now let us move towards this story. Students, in the text, The Portrait of a Lady, Khushwant Singh talks about his grandmother. Grandmother's name was Lakshmi Devi, okay? And the theme of the story is innocence, friendship, love, connection, kindness, selflessness, respect and acceptance, okay? How the writer explains all these human values, we will talk about while narrating this story, okay? Then, mode of narration, it is first person account. Okay, and it is a piece of, it's a memory piece of the author, right? Let us talk about the description of grandmother. Grandmother, when we hear the word grand, automatically old age of a person automatically comes in our mind. Okay, so grandmother was also very old, extremely old. And she was not pretty by her appearance, but she was very beautiful by her heart. Why? Let us find out. She was a spiritual by heart, religious, affectionate, adaptable, and she was morally upright, very kind-hearted lady and conservative. Okay. See, throughout the text we talk about connection of grandmother and grandson, and that happened through education. Okay, especially education is focused here of Khushwant Singh, because of which grandmother was aloof and isolated from her beloved grandson. So we need to discuss his educational description as well. At first, initially he was in village, and there in a temple he received his basic educations. After that he came to Delhi Modern School, and there he was till between the year 1920 to 1930, where he completed his first to 10th classes. After that, he went to St. Stephen's College, Delhi, where he spent his almost 2 years That is from 1930 to 1932. Okay, there he completed till class 12th. After that, he went to Government College of Lahore in the year 1932 and completed his BA in the year 1934. After that, in order to get law education, he went to King's College London and he received in the year 1938. Okay, let's move to the story now. Students, the story, The Portrait of a Lady, it is a story of grandmother which is written by grandson. Okay, now it talks about very close relationship between grandparents and grandchildren. Alright, the bond that they share is very special. The bond that they share is very precious for grandparents as well and grandchildren as well. Okay, so let us see what are the things that Khushwant Singh mentions here about his grandmother, which can be relatable to our situation as well. Okay, our life as well. Okay, at first he talks about grandmother is extremely old and she has wrinkled face. Okay, grandmother, of course, she is very old lady. Okay, she is extremely old because of which her face is also wrinkled, because old age is inevitable in nature. It comes to each and every one. Nobody can escape old age and death after old age. And at this age, we cannot expect to have beauty of youth. Yes or no? Alright, so just like other old people, even grandmother was very old and she did not have physical beauty. Okay. Since 20 years, she had been so. Since 20 years, Khushwant Singh had seen his grandmother in same situation. Okay, because she had reached to extreme point of old age. Nobody can go beyond that. Okay, their face is full of wrinkles. Okay, her back had bent. Okay, she cannot go beyond that. It shows that she had reached to her extreme old age. Alright? He could not believe she can have a husband. See, here we need to understand child psychology. Small children, in their concept, the people who are beautiful, they can only have husband. Okay, but grandmother was not beautiful at all. Therefore, how she can have husband? And remember why this point had come in his Khushwant Singh's mind. It is because grandmother used to tell her life stories to Khushwant Singh whenever she used to be free. Okay, so whenever he used to hear about grandmother's life, grandmother's youth, okay, and her childhood, how she spent it, then all these things used to be very weird for him, because I already told you, according to child psychology, children, they think about those people who are beautiful, they can only have husband. Okay, let's move ahead. Grandfather was also too old to have children. Here also the same theory can be implemented, child psychology. Okay, the people who are young, who are pretty, okay, they can have husband and wives, and not the one who are old. And Khushwant Singh had seen grandmother and grandfather in old age. Therefore, it was very hard to believe that both of them had husband and wives. Okay, and according to him, they can have only grandchildren. All right. Okay, let's move ahead. Grandmother wore white things like sari. She had white hair. Okay, silver locks she had, and then it looked just like a mountainous area which is covered with snow. Okay, and white is the symbol of peace, we all know that. Yes or no? And grandmother had same quality. She was peaceful person. Okay, she was very calm. She was not moved by happiness and neither by sadness as well. Okay, she was not pretty physically, but she was very beautiful by heart. Now what does this mean? We have already discussed that she was not pretty physically, yes or no, because of her old age, but she was beautiful by heart. It is because she cared for other beings, be it animal, be it human. And here we find grandmother imparting good parenting to grandchild, that is Khushwant Singh. See, parents should do things which children learn. Okay, indirectly, small children ape or copy their elders. Therefore, whatever grandmother did, that was copied by grandson. Okay, that is Khushwant Singh. Therefore, it was her intention as well. It was grandmother's intention to teach grandson prayer, okay, stotras and other things which were related to God and religion. Okay, so it is said that small children, in order to know a house discipline, one should see their children. And here the same thing is implementable. Okay, grandmother had done good parenting to grandchild Khushwant Singh. Therefore, we have got a gem of a person who worked for India. Okay, all right, let's move ahead. And we see grandmother was religious because entire day she used to be found with rosary. Okay, rosary is a thing by it will have 108 beads. Okay, 108 beads, and it is used for chanting prayers. Okay, so throughout the day we find grandmother with rosary and she chanted prayers. Okay, after that we find grandmother too much attached with Khushwant Singh. It is because early in the morning she used to do all the household work for which is required for Khushwant Singh's school, like making first of all giving him shower, then making him breakfast and taking him to the school. When she was in village, when grandmother was in village, she used to do everything for Khushwant Singh. Okay, this shows that she was very much attached to Khushwant Singh. Next we see, she used to read scriptures in the school. She used to take Khushwant Singh to the school, and the school was attached to a temple. Okay, it was attached to a temple and basic education was given. So while Khushwant Singh used to learn his syllabus in the temple, grandmother used to read scriptures there. Okay, and she used to wait for Khushwant Singh to complete his studies, and then both of them used to come back together. All right, Khushwant Singh learns alphabets and prayers in the temple. He used to learn alphabets, okay, and prayers. These are the basic things in the village, and their education were limited to 3 hours. Okay, in education, 3 hours means reading, writing, okay, and then arithmetic. Okay, this is called arithmetic in educational language. So this was the syllabus for village education. All right, let us see what happened next. Were they together in the city as well, or there was a change in the relationship? Till now we have found that grandmother and Khushwant Singh were very close. Okay, they loved each other, and throughout the day, throughout night, they used to spend time together. Okay, let's move ahead. Students, I have already spoken about child psychology. And another very important thing I should mention you all, and that is, small children, they are very good at imitating. Okay, they imitate especially elders. Alright, so here grandmother indirectly teaches him culture, rituals, and to be kind with animals, because she does that. She is so much attached to the culture. Okay, she performs pujas. Okay, and she follows all the rituals that are required, that are followed in Hindu religion. Okay, and she is so much attached to the animals as well. Okay, how it is known? It is known by grandmother's behavior, grandmother's habit of feeding animals, street animals. She used to make chapatis for Khushwant Singh, and stale chapatis were taken to be given to dogs, which shows that she was an animal lover. Okay, and the same quality she wanted to implement in Khushwant Singh as well. Okay, now there was a turn in the relationship. Okay, when they came to city, see, Khushwant Singh's parents had come to city because of some reason. Okay, now even he had to move to city, and here relationship of grandmother and Khushwant Singh totally changed. Now, what was the reason? Let us find out. In the city, school van took him to this school. Alright, just like village, grandmother did not require to send, did not require to take Khushwant Singh to this school because school van, school buses were plying there in the city. Okay, next we see the syllabus. There it was confined to 3 hours and little bit of prayers, but in the city they were taught geography, science, English and music as well. Alright, grandmother could not help him with all this syllabus because she was not well versed with all these subjects. She was okay with geography, she was okay with science, English as well, but she was unhappy with this lesson, that is music, because she thought that this is the task of prostitutes, okay, and those people who wanted to earn money. Alright, so this was not digestible to grandmother, but she did not interfere in the studies of Khushwant Singh. Alright, if she desired, she could have taken Khushwant Singh back to village, but she did not do that. Okay, because this syllabus was the demand of the age, demand of the modern age. Therefore, she remained quiet. Now, what grandmother did? Now, grandmother could not go with him, as I have already told you, because school buses were there. Then she could not help him with lessons, but asked that what were the syllabus that were being imparted to him. And when he said these, she was not happy with music especially. Okay, why? I told you the reason. Now, she could not feed dogs, so started feeding sparrows. In the village, she was very happily fed dogs, okay, with bread crumbs. But here it was not possible because in the city, streets were not full of dogs, which village used to have. Especially the theme cities are very much crowded with men, crowded with people, because of which animals are rarely found. Therefore, she took to feeding sparrows. She did not give excuses that I'm not finding dogs, so I will not feed anyone. She found sparrows to feed, and very soon sparrows became her best friend. With them she spent her time. Now, I have already told you this point. She did not approve new syllabus because grandmother, even though she was not educated, okay, she thought that her child should learn some lessons related to spirituality, okay, and prayers, etc. Okay. After that, when he went to university, there was total detachment. Now, one thing I must tell you, in the village they were intimate. Okay, when Khushwant Singh came to city, there was little bit of separation. Okay, now when he went to foreign country for university education, then totally both grandmother and grandson were separated. Okay, now grandmother came to drop him. Okay, send him off. For see him off at the railway station because he was going away from her for education. But at that time, because of this pain, she did not became painful. She did not cry as well. It is because she was a very balanced person. She was not happy when she got good news, okay, or happy things happened around her, and she did not cry when the situation went against her. Okay, now she continued her work. She stayed on spinning wheels. Okay, she continued her work. Okay, daily course, prayer, worshipping God, goddesses, etc. And then she continued spending her time at wheels. This is how she spent her time without Khushwant Singh. After that, she recited prayer and fed birds. Okay, these are the three things that she did. Okay, now very soon she befriended with birds. They became very close friends. Okay, Khushwant Singh by the time had already left for abroad, okay, for the completion of law degree, and at that point of time grandmother did not cry. This shows that she was very composed person. Okay, happiness did not stop her and worry did not move her at all. Let's move ahead. Students, we find grandmother as mentally balanced lady. It is because when she got happiness, okay, she received happiness, she did not become so elated, all right? And when she encountered sorrow, when her grandson left for studying, that time as well, she was not weeping, she was not found crying. This shows that she took life as simply as possible. She knew that ups and downs are part of life. Okay, the happiness that she is receiving is not going to last long, and so is the sorrow. All right, therefore, this shows this lady was mentally strong. Okay, now Khushwant Singh returns after studies, and grandmother receives him. Okay, the way she sent her sent him off, in the same way she was waiting in the station to receive him, but Khushwant Singh did not find any change in her. She was as calm and composed as before. She should be happy to see grandson. Usually that is the expectation, isn't it? When we meet our family members and beloved friends, we become so happy and hug them, right? But here grandmother was not so. Okay, she was so composed at that moment as well. Now, there was no change in grandmother. Okay, she was calm and composed. She was not sentimental when grandson left, and she was not sentimental when he came back as well. After that, instead of spending time with Khushwant Singh, she became so much engaged with her daily work. Okay, she continued her daily routine, and a change occurred in grandmother suddenly. In the evening, she collected all the ladies from the locality, and she took a drum and started singing. Okay, old age did not permit her, but she continued doing that because of which she felt ill. Now, doctor was called, and he said that she is going to be okay after medication. But grandmother knew that her death had neared, okay, and she quickly took up rosary, which she had forgotten for a while throughout her life. Okay, then we see she continues praying, and while praying she dies. Now after her death, okay, her goodwill is revealed more vividly. Okay, what happened? Family were in pain, okay, because one of the great soul had departed from their family, and not only human beings but animals as well remembered her. Even they were sad at the demise of grandmother. And when family members, especially mother of Khushwant Singh, when she threw breadcrumbs on the veranda, okay, sparrows did not pay heed to that, and they remained for a while out there, okay, in the room of grandmother. After that, they flew away. This shows that even sparrows had made, they had also established a bonding between with a grandmother, all right, and they were also sad. So it shows that when human being loves unconditionally, not only human being but even animals becomes closer to them, and it is their deed which will be remembered and not the physical beauty. Okay, so deeds are more important than the appearance. Okay, so by this we completed the story. I hope you all have understood. Now, what is the message of the story, and what, how it can be relatable to our modern life, and what are the things that should be focused in modern world? Let us discuss that. Students, one thing we need to discuss in depth related to this topic. First of all, if children or grandchildren, if they will have parent like grandmother, do you think anyone will be depressed? Anyone will be immoral? Anyone will be wild and boisterous and indisciplined? No. Isn't it? The answer is no. They will be disciplined and they will have all these qualities. But the problem is that in modern world, people want nuclear family over joint family. Okay, they want to remain aloof because they think that whatever they are earning, it should not be shared with other members of the family. Okay, if their brother or any other members are earning less, they think that they have become financial help to entire family members. They don't adjust out there. Therefore, they get separated. Now, after that, they get under financial burden. There will not be any emotional support. Okay? And the children, newborn children, are growing up in the crèche. Okay? Now, they don't find grandmother type of figure. Okay? There is nobody proper guidance for the children. They are grown under unknown person. What kind of culture, what kind of moral values they have and they are going to implement in these children, they are not heard at all. Not only that, we see children who are in crèche, they don't have emotional attachment because they don't find during their early phase of their life. After that, parents send these children for hostels. Okay, there also they find superficial love and support from their friends, but that is not pure and that is not going to remain for lifelong. All right, and eventually when they are not connected with their parents, institutions like old age homes, okay, are cropping up. They are being constructed many in the society. Okay, so these are the result of ill parenting and nuclear family. All right, if we will have our old people, our elderly people, then we will have support in house, then we will have mannerism, we will have culture, but these are the things which are lagging in the children in modern time. And this is the very grave problem. People are depressed. They don't have people to share their feelings. All right, they are depressed. They are committing suicides. Okay, they are committing other immoral things, illogical things, which are against society. Okay, remember that when you are on earth, you have to pay back. Okay, you have to give back to earth as well. Because from here only, we have got resources to grow up. And when we are grown up, we should not waste our life like that only. We should be a resource for our family members. We should be a resource to our nation and eventually a resource to our earth as well. Okay, so you might be thinking that this is very trivial issue, but good parenting is not easy task. And even parents giving up their rat race, okay, modern rat race, they should think about their children. They should spend time because of which they will have a bonding. Okay, small children will learn the value of the prize and not the price of the gift. Okay, so these are the things that we should understand from this text. I hope this text is clear to you all. And apart from this, one more thing I need to discuss, and that is there are children who beat their parents. Okay, they violate, they torture their parents. And in Indian Constitution, okay, Indian Act, Indian Penal Act, there is law which is against violence against parents. Okay, so why this was required? Because we failed somewhere. Okay, our society failed somewhere. Because if good parenting was there, then there would not have been any problem in our society. Okay, so the core problem lies here and we should rectify that. Even if we start from now, it is not going to be too late. We should come back to our culture. Thank you, students. We will meet in our next video.